The question is that motion 4938 in the name of Marie Goujon on Good Food Nation Scotland Bill be agreed, and members should cast their votes now. The vote is now closed. Point of order, Rachel Hamilton.
Presiding officer, I would have voted yes.
Thank you, Ms. Hamilton. We'll ensure that's recorded. The result of the vote on motion 4938 in the name of Marie Goujon is yes, 113. There were no votes against. There were no abstentions. The motion is therefore agreed, and the Good Food Nation Scotland Bill is passed. I propose to ask a single question on 5 parliamentary bureau motions. Does any member object? No member objects. Therefore, the final question is that motions 4999 to 5003 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. That concludes decision time.
Point of order,
Brian Whittle.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I think, as you're well aware, I'm no stranger to robust and sometimes even heated debate in this chamber. After all, we're all here because we are passionate about our country and our desire to improve the life chances of those that we represent. And we all agree on that point, I would hope, albeit we may have different routes to deliver on that. And I've said before, I think it's important in debating that we at least treat each other with a bit of respect. Yesterday, Presiding Officer, the Cabinet Secretary, Angus Robertson, in responding to very legitimate questioning from across this chamber, I believe crossed the line by devaluing the role that List MSPs have in this place. He seems to suggest that because we are not constituency MSPs, we have no right to question or scrutinise Scottish Government opinion and to represent the significant number of Scots who also disagree with him. He did so again on radio this morning. Now, I would consider branding MSPs losers for being List MSPs is hardly respectful. And can I gently suggest to Angus Robertson that he is the last person in here that should actually brand the term losers about. Presiding officer, that is not only that was not only presiding officer that not only was
members, can we please hear Mr. Whittle? Thank you.
Presiding officer, that not only was disrespectful to my esteemed colleagues Stephen Kerr and Craig Hoy in these benches, he has been disrespectful to every List MSP in this chamber, past and present. And in their ranks, presiding officer, we can include Nicola Sturgeon, 66 SNP MSPs, and even your good self, presiding officer. And to be honest, I'm surprised that someone of the stature of Angus Robertson needs to resort to such base language and tactics. Surely this kind of discourse cannot be the way in which we should treat colleagues across the chamber. Those of us involved in 2014 know the vitriol and hatred that was stoked up, and that was in no small part due to the conduct and language of those in this building, and we certainly do not want to pour petrol on that fire. So I would ask you, presiding officer, what you can do to ensure that parliamentarians conduct themselves with a bit of decorum and treat colleagues, even those we disagree with a bit of respect that they would want afforded to themselves. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Whittle. I responded to a related point yesterday, and I would say that if any member in this chamber were to suggest that the status of regional and constituency members differed, I will intervene. Constituency and regional members have equal status as members of the Scottish Parliament. The Scotland Act and the Standing Orders make no distinction in terms of the powers they have in representing constituents and scrutinising and holding the government to account. The presiding officers act impartially, taking account of the interests of all members equally. Mr. Whittle is right, of course. Debate in the chamber can be robust and passionate, and I will take this opportunity to remind all members of the requirement, understanding orders and the code of conduct, to treat each other with courtesy and respect at all times. Thank you.